Hey everyone, it's Tom Kradzer with another Rockstar Minute. And this summer, we've been asking everyone around here what advice you'd give your 21-year-old self. And Andrew's an interesting case. You're still young. How old are you?
34.
Mid-30s. Oh, he's getting old. So he's an interesting case because you started buying properties pretty early. You just got back from Turks and Caicos because you own a property there. You look like you're in beach mode which is a good thing. But I'm curious, what advice? Where were you when you were 21? Like, what state of mind and what advice would you give that person? Here, hold the mic. There you go.
Sure. When I was 21, I was working four jobs and still saving. I was saving up for real estate, but I bought my first property at 22. And if I could have gone back, I would have bought it at 21. I bought a Cadillac at 21 or 20.
So you had your priorities straight. Yeah. You bought the Cadillac first. So that's the advice you give your 21-year-old self: buy the property
real first. Estate first, cars second.
And has it panned out? Have you had to face any fears in your real estate journey, or has it panned out?
Yeah, everything kind of worked out. You just ignore the fears and don't listen to people. Because people that are older than you often are scared for you because they weren't able to do it. But when you're young, you don't know better, so you have no fear.
So you didn't listen to those older people?
No.
Can you explain, like, why didn't you? Because that's most people's fear. It comes from other people, and they put those fears on themselves. Why didn't you listen to those people? Like, how did you get through that?
I think I did. At the time, I didn't listen because I wasn't good with authority. But looking back, I now know that those people weren't saying anything to try and hurt me. They were just scared for me. They were trying to protect me. It came from a good place. But everyone who tells you not to invest or not to do something, they mean well, but they just don't know. Unless they've gone through it, they don't know better.
Okay, last question. What about the people who say, hey, Andrew, it's top of the market right now. Do not buy now because, quote unquote, we all know we're buying at the top. What would you say to that?
Buy now, just in case it's not. And then hold it for 20 years.
And buy because of the income on the property?
Buy it for the long-term appreciation, the mortgage pay down, and the cash flow.
Yeah, cool. Thanks for this, man.
Yeah, no problem.
Until next time, your life, your terms.